ओम श्री गणेशाय नमः, ओम सरस्वत्यै नमः, ओम सद्गुरुभ्यो नमः। श्री अरुणाचलम, श्री अरुणाचलम, श्री अरुणाचलम। गुड मॉर्निंग एंड हरि ओम टू ऑल द डिवोटीज फ्रॉम ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड। ग्रीटिंग्स फ्रॉम अरुणाचल। टुडे we are going to take a question from one Mrs. Jnana Tulasi. She is a volunteer teacher at an orphanage for girls in Colombo, Sri Lanka. She is a devotee of Sri Ramakrishna Mission and a very sincere seeker. Her question: Swamiji, I would like to understand the significance of prayers. We were told to pray for the welfare of everyone, that is lokakshemam, from our childhood. However, even after praying intensively for the welfare of the world, most of the time the prayers are unanswered. Example, coronavirus. As far as I know, everyone is praying to get rid of it, but instead it is thriving. So what's the point of prayers? Is karma stronger than prayers? My mind gets disappointed and doesn't agree to pray while wholeheartedly. Agree to pray wholeheartedly, since at the corner of the mind something says, anyway, nothing is going to change. If karma and prarabdha alone drives the results, maybe it is for my own sake and as a spiritual practice, should I pray without expecting results? But haven't we set the wrong expectation about the prayers at our childhood? Please enlighten me why we should pray for the welfare of the world. Jnana, what you have asked is a very logical question, but I tell you, a very tough one. Initially I thought I would rather leave it in choice, skip the question, then thought, okay, let me give it a try. At the outset, I want to honestly confess that I don't know the real answer. I am going to think loudly. If it makes sense, well and good. If not, Sarvam Shri Brahmarpanamastu. First of all, Gurudev Swami Chinmayanji says, prayer is not begging for something from a higher power or God sitting above the clouds somewhere. It is invoking the grace and blessings of the Lord, the power and strength from within, by tuning ourselves with the Lord of our own heart. I will repeat. Prayer is not begging for something from a higher power or a God sitting above the clouds somewhere. It is invoking the grace and blessings of the Lord, the power and strength from within, by tuning ourselves with the Lord of our own heart. Therefore, when we pray sincerely, we are blessed by the Lord residing in our own heart to live a dharmic life, to resist all temptations and to seek the higher without getting lost in the samsara. The best prayer is not to ask the Lord, give me this or that, order him to do this way or that way. It is to say, with an attitude of total surrender, enneni vetra ennuire ennam eduvo adu seivai kanne undan kalalinayir kaadar peruke taruvai. Meaning, I do not know, O Lord, what is good or bad for me or for the world. You do whatever you think fit, whatever is auspicious. My only submission is, O Lord, let the devotion to your lotus feet ever swell in my heart. O Lord, let the devotion to your lotus feet ever swell in my heart. This is from Bhagavan Sri Ramana Maharshi's Arunachala Navamanimalai. This is the way to pray in total surrender. The Lord is the one who has created the world, running the show, and when the time comes, who winds up everything, saying, enough is enough. Is he not the omnipotent, the all-knower, and omnipotent, the all-powerful one? Does he not know his business? What to do, when to do, and how to do? Is he not the compassionate one? Avyaja Karuna Murti? Will he ever give any pain or sorrow to anybody without any reason? Who are we to tell him, O Lord, kindly take care of the world, kindly help the beings, blah, blah, blah. Are we intelligent than him? Are we more compassionate than him? What do we know about the mysteries of the existence here? We have come yesterday and would vanish tomorrow like an insignificant moth. What an audacity to remind him of his business, as if we are the protector of all beings. What an arrogance. If there is COVID today, it is his way of resetting the world. Maybe it is his way of showing our place, meaning, with so much of scientific and technological advancements, we are clueless, helpless, even after 6 months. Man, out of ignorance and arrogance, thinks he can do anything. Probably, this is a way to make him humble. Man thinks he can destroy any life at will for his own pleasure. He can eat anything, dog, cat, snake, or even bat. To show him, it'll come back. He may have to pay heavy price here for this cruelty. Maybe the Lord have let loose this virus. Who knows? Therefore, to think we know everything, or only we have got the heart to feel and say, he has let us down in spite of our sincere prayers, is all childish. In the world, if a farmer prays for the rain, and his son prays sincerely for not having rain, as he has planned to play cricket with his friends, whose prayers the Lord should answer? Think. A thief or a burglar who is attempting to break open the hundi of the temple, he too sincerely prays before his mission to the same Lord that everything should go smoothly without any vignam. Is it not so? And he should not be caught. What will the Lord do now? Will he protect his hundi or his devotee? Think. Therefore, we need not remind him his business, his duties. He knows all. Then, why our elders have asked us from our childhood to pray for the welfare of the world? Loka samasta sukino bhavantu is a famous Vedic prayer of our rishis, meaning, let all the beings everywhere be happy. Why should we pray thus? Probably our great rishis must have felt the man, out of his selfishness, is always praying only for the welfare of his family, his wife and children, and becoming more and more small, more and more mean. At least if he prays, let all the beings be happy, his mind may expand and would embrace the whole universe, which is good for his spiritual evolution. Moreover, when a devotee expands and identifies more and more with beings around him, when he sees suffering around him, his heart naturally melts. Vaadiya vairai kandabodellam vaadinen, said a great devotee. And his lips naturally utters this universal prayer to the Almighty. That is, Loka Samastha Sukhino Bhavantu. It is not expecting that the Lord, after hearing his prayers, is going to wipe away all the sorrows from the world in one stroke. It is not possible. It is because his heart has expanded now, and he identifies not only with this body, but with the whole universe. That is why he is sending out this universal prayer, Loka Samastha Sukhino Bhavantu. Similarly, the elders must have thought, if the child is encouraged to pray for the welfare of the world, the child would expand within and would feel for the suffering of others and would serve the fellow beings when it grows up to be an adult. This is the only reason I could think of. There may be some other reasons too, but definitely not to wipe away all suffering in one stroke. Let the Creator take care of his world. Let us serve the fellow beings around in whatever way possible with love and dedication. Maybe one of the ways is to pray for their well-being. Therefore we shall pray sincerely, Loka Samastha Sukhino Bhavantu. Jnana, does this answer make some sense to you? Anyway, may the Lord, the kind Lord, give you more clarity from within regarding this. Om Tat Sat. Now, we are going to take another question from a seeker from Chennai. She doesn't want to be identified, so I am not taking her name. Her question: Swamiji, when one section of people propagate the Nama chanting, the other section says the liberation is possible only through knowledge. I feel Nama chanting gives Chitta Shuddhi, in which Vedantic teachings get embossed. And Nama is continued further as a part of sadhana to maintain the luster of the vessel. I think by vessel, here she means mind or the antakkarana. We have so many stories like Ajamilan, Kannappa Nayanar, etc. This hunter is liberated. Is it due to homework of yesteryear births, or he had learnt Vedanta? Tat ekam vada nishchaya. This is her question. Amma, Nama, the name of the Lord, is Parama Pavanam, Parama Pavitram. It definitely purifies the heart and take anyone to the ultimate liberation. No doubt about that. Especially in Kali Yuga, it is said in Srimad Bhagavatam that this is the most potent means to realize the God. In our own times, Papa Ramdas Ji of Kanchengadu have realized the Lord through continuous chanting of the name of the Lord. Yes, Ajamilan and Kannappa from our Puranas too have attained the feet of the Lord through pure devotion. Nobody contradicts. If you are very inspired by the path shown by the great devotees, please, by all means, follow the path with unbroken attention. But only thing, it is not chanting the name for, say, an hour or two. sitting on a stage with mic and accompaniments for applause and doing whatever you want after that. Sorry, that is not the way. Doing this way, if you feel it is enough because this is Kali Yuga, we can only say sorry. It doesn't happen that way. Kadalagi kasindu kanneer malugi oduvar thammai uivippadu. I will repeat. Kadalagi kasindu kanneer malugi oduvar thammai uivippadu. Vedam naangilum meipporulavadu naadan naamam namashivayave. Naadan naamam namashivayave. Therefore, just taking nama is not sufficient. Kadalagi kasindu kanneer malugi. With a heart melting in devotion, we have to take his nama. And it is not enough if we take just say for an half an hour or an hour. Maybe Tuesday and Fridays. That is not enough. If you are taking this as your sadhana, it has to be continuous, unbroken. Then only it will take you to the ultimate goal. If somebody wants to follow Vedanta Margam, let them follow. It is also given by our great masters, indicated by the great scriptures. At the same time, if somebody wants to integrate Bhakti and Vedanta and feels that it is only suiting that temperament, let them do that way. Whichever pill is curing your bhavarogam, please take it and get rid of the suffering as soon as possible. I will repeat. Whichever pill is curing your bhavarogam, please take it and get rid of the suffering as soon as possible. That is all. Why to argue and quarrel and waste the precious time? There is nothing like ekam vada nishchitya and all here. It is all childish. Vivekananda says, as many seekers, so many paths are available here. That is the glory of our Sanatana Dharma. Like all the paths take you to the peak of that mountain. Like all the rivers that ultimately merge into the ocean. Swami Vivekananda says, all these paths ultimately take a seeker to his goal of self-realization. Therefore, it is not the spirit of Sanatana Dharma to say, my God alone will save. The rest of the gods are Satans. That is not the spirit of Sanatana Dharma. Sanatana Dharma is so beautiful. Whichever form you worship, in whichever way you worship, taking whatever name, the Lord Almighty will come to you in that form, in that name, and he will bless you. Similarly, whatever path you take with sincerity, that will lead you to the ultimate goal. So please understand, there is nothing like one marga here in Sanatana Dharma. All the path will lead to the ultimate goal. Om Tat Sat. Brahmarpanamastu. Krishna, Krishna, Krishna.